Kowski. B-Cop says he located a green Kaiser Frazier from the hot sheet. Address is 6 West 2nd Street. Get over there and see what you can find out. Go on. Sorry to inconvenience you.
We're on it, Captain.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to L.A. Noire. In the last episode, we finished up a marriage made in heaven. And now we're doing, as you can see, a slip of the tongue. Going to investigate a car stolen, a Frazier, or something like that. Come on, Bukowski, keep up. Okay, here we go. Okay, off we go.
They're calling her the Dahlia. Wonder what's wrong.
Who is her? Nice airtime there.
You hear whether they're making any progress? Captain Donnelly seems to think they have it all wrapped up. Brown and Green are sweating this manly character. I heard it'll be in front of a grand jury by next week.
Ooh, that's close.
Fourth. Terrible enough to be murdered like that. Now that it's strewn all over the front.
All right. Weaving in and out of the traffic. Okay, don't hit me. Nice. I nailed it. Yeah, excuse me. Okay. 6 West 2nd Street, 12:21 p.m.
That's the car, Cole. Just pulling out of the drive. Get it.
It's an ugly car.
Remember, we need him healthy enough to answer questions.
Flip the car. Got it.
1247, Detective.
Nice red car.
Requesting immediate backup in pursuit of a stolen green Kaiser Frazier from 6 West 2nd Street.
Are you going onto the highway and on ramp? Excuse me. Come on.
Lay into his wheel arch. Come on.
Dude, come on. Don't need to hit other people.
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
All right, all right. Maybe I was a couple miles over the speed limit.
Put your hands in the air!
So violent.
Why did you run from us?
I saw a big car in my rearview mirror with two tough guys bearing down on me. What would you do?
What's your name?
Cliff Harrison.
You're under arrest.
You heard the siren, you idiot.
What are you talking about?
Nice try. I'm talking about the car being stolen.
You're out of your mind. I bought the car, and I've got the paperwork to prove it.
Cliff Harrison, 6 West 2nd Street. That's where we just were. 1947. Kaiser Frazier. 2450 for, I mean, it looks like a nice car for the time. I'd pay that much for that kind of car. Holy cow, it's nice. I mean, this money I don't have, but still. Okay, vehicle reported as stolen.
This car from Coombs Automotive Company.
Yeah, that's right.
Looks like he's telling the truth. Let's go to the truth.
And the ownership papers?
From the same place.
Automotive certificate of ownership. Cliff Harrison. Kaiser Frazier. Frazier Manhattan. Register fees 190. Hmm. 6 West 2nd Street, LA. Same address. Motive for flight.
Do you have a criminal record, Mr. Harrison?
No. Nothing like that.
He seemed very flamboyant and smiled, and he's blinking a crap ton. Doubt.
You better give us something, Cliff. We're gonna make this hard on you.
I didn't steal the car. I ran because Because I've got some wacky-backy in the glove compartment.
How much, Cliff?
One reefer.
We'll let it slide. You're in enough trouble. Who did you deal with at Coombs Automotive?
Oh, jeez.
Richard Coombs.
Coombs. Is it Combs or Coombs? Looks like he's telling the truth. Same thing as him the first time.
And he made out the bill of sale, personally?
Of course he did. He kept a facsimile for his records. Check with him.
I don't know what that is, but okay.
We're going to get to the bottom of this, Harrison. Until we do, you're going downtown.
You gotta be kidding me! I'm getting arrested for buying a goddamn car!
Alright, rank 10.
Legit, Harrison, you'll be out soon. Until then, if I were you, I'd keep my mouth shut. Bag his possessions as evidence. Have him arraigned for grand theft auto.
Right, Detective. Grand theft auto, wow.
We need nope, to don't care. And check out
bye, buddy.
Story.
Go around me. Jeez. Rude.
I think he's telling the truth. Some of the most convincing people you will ever listen to are born liars. Usually they're called politicians.
Ouch. That's appropriate for today. Can I get a dispatch, please? There's nothing on the way over to the...
See some kid who's basically you 5 years ago and assume he's got to be innocent.
Oh, jeez.
Hey, if he'd been black or Hispanic, you'd be singing a different tune.
Wow, that's pulling the racist card.
The same, but it only works one way.
I'm not sure that's communism.
Oh, not another history lesson from the man who single-handedly won the war.
Are you finished?
Yes. I feel much better. We'll shake down the car dealer and take it from there. Unless daddy
plays golf with yours, of course. In which case, we'll give him a firm gentleman's handshake and be on our way. See? We look downtown over there. Excuse you. I'm a cop. Don't honk your horn at me like that. I like the newscast, it's like old-timey sounding, it's kind of cool. Coombs Automotive, is that it right there? Great cars, great prices. Coombs Automotive Company, used cars. Oh, it was a used car, that's why it was cheaper. I wonder how much a new car went for back in 1947.
Sedan that would be absolutely perfect for you.
Detective Phelps, LAPD, are you the owner?
That's right. Richard Coombs at your service.
Okay,
you
Coombs.
Looking to trade in a black and white, boys?
Mr. Coombs, we're investigating an auto theft. A man by the name of Cliff Harrison claims he bought the car here.
Well, some people would say that my cars are a steal. That's a joke, son.
Very amusing, Mr. Coombs.
I remember Harrison. Green two-tone Kaiser Fraser, if I remember rightly.
Do you have the bill of sale?
It's in my office. Walk this way.
Ooh, some Aerosmith. What is... Oh my god, that's scary.
It's a joke too, son.
Phelps, you mind if I shoot this guy? He's getting on my nerves.
Go ahead, Bukowski. Go ahead.
Sure I can't interest you in a nearly new car, son? I'm all but giving them away to servicemen and cops.
Ooh.
Here it is. Got the original pink slip there, too.
You can press E to stand up. Gene Archer.
Gene Archer. 146 North Fremont Avenue.
Yeah, Gene Archer. What? Marquee Printing Company? Okay. And Harrison, that checks out.
Harrison's purchase receipt was legit, at least.
So he paid for the car. I think. That's what that means. So can I stand up?
We have a couple of questions.
All right, fellas. Shoot.
How you doing, sir? What's in your pocket? Okay, details of the transaction.
How you came to buy the car?
Girl just wandered in right off the street.
I'm gonna say that's the truth.
Nothing unusual about the car.
Not really my usual type of vehicle. The price was certainly right, though. Nice girl, about as sharp as a bag of wet mice.
Did you pay with check or cash?
A check. She wanted it made out to cash, but I insisted. Man has to watch his cash flow.
What name?
I made it out to Gene Archer on the...
Oh, pink slip. That's... okay. I think I understand how those work now. Description of suspect.
Can you describe this Gene Archer?
Brunette, maybe 25, 26. A little on the plump side, but not bone ugly.
That's rude. Why would he lie about that? I'm gonna go with the truth on that one, too.
What was your impression of her?
Kind of harried and harassed. In a hurry to go somewhere, but no place to go. You get to know the type.
Okay. Association with Marquis. Oh, that's the printing company.
The company that prints these pink slips?
Nope. Should I? It isn't exactly my business.
He's kind of leaning forward more and staring right into me this time. I'm gonna go with... he's more uptight. I'm gonna go doubt.
These pink slips are leading us to something big, Coons. It's time to stop being cute.
I'm going to assume you're having a bad day, son. I sell cars, not paper.
Okay, got that one wrong.
When exactly did you hand over the check, Mr. Coons?
Close of play on Friday.
Yeah, okay, definitely doubt there.
Why didn't you pay her cash? You knew the car was dirty.
I had an inkling. When people are in a hurry for money, always pay by check, son. Gives you a couple days to back out.
Okay, got that. Suspicious transaction.
That was all above board.
Yes, of course it was.
Okay, yeah, come on, dude. Do we have any evidence to say otherwise? I mean, I have nothing, so I don't have to go with doubt.
Did this look legitimate to you, Coombs?
I'm in used cars, son, not bearer bonds. In my business, you don't look a gift horse in the mouth. Now don't come on all high and mighty with me if you want my help.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Coombs. We need to continue the investigation.
Hope you sort out your problem with Mr. Harrison. Go easy on him, son. Boy's about as sharp as a bowling ball. He's built too low. The fastballs fly over his head.
Let me shoot this guy, please. You have a pleasant day, Mr. Coombs.
Let me shoot this guy, please. Coming after you, buddy. The other day. Okay. Bye-bye. Can I read any of that? That's just all scribble. Okay. Let's go.
Harrison might be off the hook, but we can still run an APB on Gene Archer. Get on the horn and call it in.
Should take his used car. Take the car he's trying to sell and total it. Oh, I'd love to do that, but I can't. Oh, I can talk to police people. Nice flowers. Where's the phone? Oh, it's over here.
Phelps, badge 1247.
What's on the other side?
How can I help, Detective?
Requesting an APB on Gene Archer, age approximately 25, on suspicion of Grand Theft Auto.
I'll relay the information.
I need an address on a marquee printing company.
Marquee printing company, sure. Just a moment. Aliso Street, near San Pedro.
Messages, please.
Cool.
A James Belasco is being held at Central Station on suspicion of GTA. Possible link to the Harrison case. They're waiting on you to conduct the interview.
Oh, come on. I have three places to go. Okay, well, I think I'm just going to go in order. Back to the car, Bukowski. Ooh, a taxi. That's a cool looking taxi. Why can't we have taxis like that? Okay, 146 Fremont Avenue.
Call it evidence. Guy's an asshole. You pick it up in town.
Okay, off we go to 146 Fremont Avenue.
Do you think you have to be an asshole to sell cars? Or that selling cars turns you into an asshole? You've got to do everything.
Oh, jeez.
I've always got an interest in car sales. Doesn't matter what day. And why do they always think they're comedians when they're about as funny as a heart attack?
Maybe the more annoying they are, the quicker you sign on the dotted line, just to get the hell out of there.
That's a good point. Excuse you. Okay, off we go. Can we get a dispatch call soon? I like the action. No! I mean, it's kind of nice if we're just going straight along with the case, but come on. There's nothing here.
Empty. Should have known that Archer Broad would have given us a false address.
Hmm.
We should go to the station. This Belasco guy has to say.
Let's go to the printing company first. I wonder what the R is on the back of the cab. Is it promotional for something? Yeah, probably. There's a Coke one in the back of that one. Ooh, oh, gosh. Got a hang time there. Probably should have turned a road later, but all. Do trolleys have horns on them? Excuse you. Whoops.
I'd rather get there in one piece.
Quiet. Marquee Printing Company. And I think, I don't know. Let's go in and talk to him for a little bit. Okay, going in this store.
Go bug someone else, huh?
Wow, rude. Smoking will kill you, jerk.
What can I do for you, gentlemen?
I'm a traffic detective from Central Division. Who's in charge here?
I am, Gordon Lightfall. What's this about?
We understand that you're
another Gordon.
California vehicle titles.
Yes, I have the government contract to print pink slips. I've done for some years.
Have you had any goods or equipment stolen recently? We're running up against stolen cars with seemingly legitimate paperwork.
Not recently. Have you ruled out forgery? There's no shortage of talented artists in this town.
We'll keep it in mind.
He seemed really sketchy. What are you doing, Bukowski? We shouldn't take a seat. Oh, you smoke? You're disgusting. Well, In the next episode, I think we're going to go to the Central Police Department to interrogate the guy. So until then, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. God bless. See you then.